What's the best part about being an entrepreneur? You know what's the best thing about being an entrepreneur? It's freaking uncomfortable. And that's where all the growth happens. It's an addiction. The adrenaline rush of a sales call that was too big for you, the overwhelming emotion of winning an award, the desperation after losing a contract. It's like bungee jumping. I am more than convinced that I would have never been able to become as resilient as I am now with OIT jumping into entrepreneurship in my 20s. It forced me to ask the tough questions in life that many people put off until their midlife crisis. I am glad I need to ask myself, why the heck I am doing THAT I'm doing, every single day. Entrepreneurship forces you to take ownership of your life and figure out your why. It's not fun. I lost two big contracts early on my career. I remember nights lying awake feeling like my mind was physically torturing me. Stretching me. It hurt. But it got better and I learned to separate my identity from my business. I can lose a contract without it ruining my week now. I have control over my emotions. I stopped worrying about the little stuff that I used to complain about before jumping into entrepreneurship. I learned that the worst-case scenario rarely happens. You might as well take risks. Entrepreneurship is not all freedom. Work from wherever you want to, and do what you love. It's a roller coaster of self-discovery with lows far outside your comfort zone but highs far higher than you've ever experienced. I remember the moment clear as if it was yesterday. I was just finishing a meeting in our large conference room. I walked out of the room with my guest, and I heard this low roar of people. I knew that roar because I had experienced it before. That roar was the buzz, the energy of a team of people working really well together. I walked my guest out to the lobby and shook his hand. Then I walked back into our offices, and I just stood and listened to the roar. That was the moment I knew we had arrived. Every moment up until then had been building towards this. Every person we hired, every product we released, every customer that started buying from us led to this moment. I am smiling right now thinking about that moment. The camaraderie. The sheer fun of building something against all odds. The rush of getting customers to buy from you. You just can't beat it. That feeling that you have built something from scratch and you know you are going to succeed was the peak for me. It was such an incredible feeling because we had struggled so hard for so long. There were so many near-death experiences we had to get to this point. And, little did I know, there would be so many near-death experiences to follow. However, for that moment, I felt so good, and I was so happy. Oh, how I wish it would go on forever. There are steps you can take to build that buzz at your startup, eh? It all starts with you. You have to have a fervent belief in yourself and your company. You will fail without belief, read. Why You Need Fanatical Co-Founders, Brett J. Fox. Because you will not make it through all the roadblocks you will inevitably face. Then. B. You need a great team. The older and more experienced I get, the more I see the correlation between having a great team and success. It's just so difficult to build something with mediocre people. And why would you want to work with mediocre people? You'll spend your time handholding your mediocre team and cleaning up after them. Tell me how that can be any fun. What's fun, at least to me, is watching a great team execute at a high level. That's what helps build that buzz. Finally. C. You need to provide your great team with a great culture. Again, it all comes back to you. Don't hire that brilliant jerk you're thinking of hiring, no matter how brilliant the jerk might be. Instead, pay careful attention to the culture and environment you want in your company. Pay your team fairly and give them the autonomy and freedom to make decisions. Give your team exciting and interesting things to work on. Then, keep hiring great people as your company continues growing. And that's how you keep the buzz going.